What is up, YouTube? It's Kuda Below here, coming at you with another exciting video. Doing another walk around of this Warbonnet Superfly rain tarp or tarp. You could use it in windy weather, you could use it for snow, you could use it for rainy conditions. Kind of doing a little walk around my campsite, showing you how I staked it down, tied it to a tree over there. We are camping in the beautiful San Gabriel Mountains. This is my view. Wow, what a beautiful morning to wake up to. Cold. It's probably in the 40s right now, low 40s, probably maybe even upper 30s. But if you've been watching the last few videos, you see that I'm doing some hammock camping out in the wilderness out here. And this is the Warbonnet Superfly tarp. So love this thing. Just wanted to give a shout out to the Warbonnet people. Basically, what I did was I got some stakes. Right, use some 1.8 millimeter paracord, staked it down, and then for the top, for the ridge line, basically used the 550 paracord, which is like this stuff. This is my accessory line, so I can hang up my boots and gloves and that kind of stuff. But let me show you how I hung this tarp, just so we can all get a perspective of that. So what I did was I put the tarp over the paracord, so the paracord will kind of take up some of the weight of the tarp. And then basically I have 1.8 millimeter paracord here that I loop through the ring to an S-beaner. And I try to use the heavier duty ones. Like, this is a 75 pounder and you're thinking, well, the tarp only weighs like probably less than a pound or a pound or whatever. Why do you need a 75 pound carabiner on either side? Well, when the wind does kick up and you're trying to get your, let's say you have snake skins and you're trying to pull your snake skins over, this tarp is basically one huge sail, so you need something a little stronger to hold it in case it gets windy. So anyways, the S-beaner connects to more 1.8 millimeter paracord that I did a prussic knot on, or a prussic loop. And basically, as you can see there, it's coiled over a few times. So that's basically what's holding it. But if I need to adjust this, I can just pull from the prussic loop. See how easy it slides? But once it's set and you try to pull it, it's not going anywhere, right? So then what I'll do is I'll leave the prussic loop on the paracord. When I pack it away, I'll pull off the S-beaner, obviously, and then I'll pull off the tarp. So that way I can keep the paracord with a like an accessory bag that I know is meant for this tarp. Or sometimes I'll actually stuff the paracord with the tarp. I try to avoid doing that though, like that would only be an emergency. But I try to avoid putting the paracord with the tarp because I don't want anything to rub against the tarp, like abrasiveness, you know, that kind of vibe. So anyways, the paracord, 550 paracord, goes back into this tree right here, went around, and then on this side, it kind of got smushed, but there's a trucker's knot right there with a, I think this is a half hitch coming back into it. And this is the reflective 550 paracord that I like using. There's some more people going up to their hike or whatever. But anyways, with the excess paracord, I just basically bundled it up like this and left it like a marker. So if somebody's walking through the campsite at night, their headlight would hit this and it would reflect back and they would know, hey, wait, there's a tarp or something going on. So that's why I always, always, always try to use reflective paracord as much as possible. But anyways, you get the idea. And then on the other side of the tree, I basically did the same thing where I went around the tree with the paracord to basically suspend the tarp. You get the idea. So let's come over to this side. I got creative, right? Because I was close to a tree. So instead of using tent stakes, I basically wrapped some of the 1.8 millimeter paracord around this corner of the tarp. And then over here, this is my door, or one of the two doors. And what I do here is the same thing. I could have staked this down, but I just went around a tree. You know, use whatever's available, right? Less gear you have to use, the better. And then basically to keep the doors closed, I have another S-beaner down here. This one is a number, what is that, a number? Number two, this one's rated for 10 pounds, right? I'm just trying to keep the doors closed. Nothing really, you know, dramatic here or whatever. But when I want to get in and out, I could just unclip the S-beaner like that and then unclip the door. See if I can do this with one hand. Ah, there we go. And then my door's open. Then I can go back inside of my hammock setup inside or whatever. And then nighttime, what I'll do is I'll just close that. And there you go. So let me come over to another nice wide angle shot and show you all what's happening. Don't want to lose my footing. So there you go. So there is the Warbonnet Superfly tarp. It's not perfectly hung, but you know, it'll do. It basically kept all of the morning dew off of me. it kept me a little more warmer than, say, not having it, especially in the winter months. But I love it, and it's doing a good job so far. I can't complain. What I'm missing, what I didn't bring on this trip, was the snakeskins. So basically, the snakeskins are like, they kind of look like pantyhose, and most of the time they're made out of mosquito netting. And basically what happens is I would string them on the paracord and leave that on there. And then basically when I wrap up the tarp, what I could do is I could wrap up the tarp if it's getting windy, and then pull the snake skin. So it's like a sock that basically envelops the tarp. And then that way it's just a tube that's rolling in the wind instead of a sail that's catching the wind. Does that make sense? Yes. No, I hope so. Okay, anyways, there are many links in the description there down below. I will put a link to Warbonnet's website so you can check all their stuff out as well. Also, down in the description, there's a link to my Facebook page. It's Cooter Molloy Product Reviews. Make sure to check that out. Please hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. Also, hit the notification bell, and I will look forward to seeing you on a future video. But the short, quick explanation, this is all bonus material, is the reason why you want the tarp is for rainfall, for wind protection, for sun protection, in case it's snowing where you are. What I could always do is, with that trucker's hitch setup that I attached it to the tree, what I could always do is I could always lower it down. I could always lower this paracord down and basically create like a, almost like a tent or like a bivy type setup, so that if it's lower to the ground, there's less likelihood of the wind actually getting in there, picking it up and turning it into a sail like in the middle of the night. Right, so that's the reason why we'd want to lower it. During the day, what I could do is, this is my accessory line, right? And there's a good, I'd say there's a good like 4 feet of space right here. So what I would do is, during the day, I'll pick up this corner, attach it to this side, and then pick up this corner down here and attach it to this side of my accessory line. And then now what I could do is I could create a little bit of like a shelf. I think it's called the shelf, or like the patio porch mode, right? Where I'm opening up one side to maybe let a little bit of a light, gentle breeze in, and at the same time, maybe just airing out whatever's in there. So like if I wanted to sit in my hammock and just enjoy this beautiful view right here, I could do that, right? And just sit down in my hammock, open this up to porch mode, right? So looking at it from the side, basically this side of the tarp would come up over this, right? And then that way I could have this beautiful view right here. So there you go. I'm Cooter Molloy, asking everybody to subscribe down below, and I will catch you all on the next exciting video.